With the beautiful Puget Sound just to our west, you get a look inside Lumen Field here in Seattle, Washington. Today, we start the new year with an NFC matchup out west, as it'll be the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Seattle Seahawks. Two teams more than ready to get this one started. And off we go from Seattle. And no return here to start. It's a fair catch, and they will set up shop at the 25.
Football defense.
Jump for the pass, D.
Come on, defense.
Set it down, D.
Don't let them complete.
Throw outside complete. That's Lloyd. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
Heck of a play there to get to him quickly and get him down for a loss.
I think they did a really nice job getting ready for this game, scouting, watching film, and understanding defensively what the play design was.
Don't let him get there.
Defense, you're weak.
Now on second down, this is goal. Maybe a gain of a yard that time. Two catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out, but I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Right in the event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. He finds his man complete. It's Lloyd. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on third and two. Well, that's not just his first, not his second, already his third completion here on the opening drive. And I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And a top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him. And I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
They go on the screen. And he is going to lose yardage here. 2 yards the loss, and now third. And a good time. And their young quarterback confident on the open.
Now we have a young quarterback. It doesn't matter. We have met a quarterback that doesn't tell us he's confident about his abilities, right?
That's true.
But when you're young, it's really important to get off to a good start because it does build up that confidence that allows him to play better as the game goes on.
Especially crucial here on the road. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. Call it a gain of 6 on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far in the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
And this one is right down Broadway. Well, all offseason, probably a lot of thought goes into that first drive of week one. They didn't get
get the touchdown, but at least they got something.
And what I like about it is that they didn't overthink it, because you're exactly right. A lot goes into the offseason, the preseason, to get to that first drive of the regular season. They went right downfield, mission accomplished, points on the board.
Certainly welcome most of his passes this year going as well as that. Now that the first one is over, time to settle into a groove and begin the long journey to week 18 and hopefully the playoffs.
And this will be a Seahawks first down as the tackle made just shy of the 40.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Down the field, offense, come on!
Keep the ball moving!
Running game working, will stick with it on first down. Taken down at the 42.
Good to win!
And they'll come up second and seven. Keep it on the ground. Alexander, and very little daylight there. They'll get a couple up to the 44. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
From the gun on third down, Wallace. Intercepted. Pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, it needs to be fourth down. The Seahawks send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. A 7-yard return following a punt of 45 yards. And the 49ers will take over deep in their own territory.
That's what we do.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I should like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
Drops it underneath the goal. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. They just enjoy a play like that. The defense to a linebacker. This is a receiver downfield.
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Okay. This is like watching.
Now a first down throw with Smith. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawk defense. They wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down.
That time, it looked like he essentially just ran right into the pass rush.
Yeah, partner, I'm not much of an outdoorsman, but the fish jumped right into the net, didn't he? Because you've got to make sure that you're deep enough that you can get around the defensive end and have an angle there. But he couldn't do it because he actually cut
it. Well, tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30.
Alexander. He'll get about six there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line. Three nothing after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Seattle. It is the Seahawks with the football here as they've got it with a second and four coming up. Off the play fake. Walsh. And look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. That one good for 16 as the drive continues.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Looking to throw. Wallace. He's got it. Touchdown. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. That's why you got your star out there. Throw the ball to him. They did.
I don't care what coverage you put out there. He's so good. We're going there.
Touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Yeah, that's what we do. That's what we do.
We'll take that. Thank you.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they want to try to get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
And there's a throw right side taken in by his tight end.
He's a rookie. Defense! Defense! But when you see defense!
First down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up, but I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
On first down, it's Smith. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. A gain of 10 and a 49er first down.
But they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
First down, it's goal. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Play action. It's Smith. It's complete. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 33. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Well, every now and then I can speak from experience because I do know as a defender, it is awfully hard to stay with your man on these crossing routes because even if you don't get picked, there's a danger of being picked either by one of the receivers or your own defender. And on that
28-yard line.
If you're a coach, you'll absolutely take that run every time on first down because it really sets you up to go in a number of directions here on second.
From the 28, it's second and five. Now Smith. It's complete. It's good. And they'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
Necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Smith. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
And they backs up against the wall. And they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Smith. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete.
Oh, what are we doing?
And it gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
A chance for a first touchdown drive of the year. It's first and goal.
Go defense, one stop.
Smith. Flush to his right. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
Again, Smith.
That interception.
Here, and that's complete. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal.
When you run draft,
you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
A big play, if you think about it right now, in this season opener. It's third and goal. Now Smith. He's left with no option here but to throw it away. It's been a long drive. They held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
And his kick is good. So a long drive gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just a field goal.
I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the 3, and I think it was a smart move.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
This well upfield across the 45. 23 yards the pickup there.
Let's go now.
Run that ball down the field.
Go! Pressure again!
make some good plays today.
On first down, Wallace. He finds his man complete. That's Stevens. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Back to throw. Wallace. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you don't get a good one like that, the offer can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Not liking the look, they'll change the play. On first and 10, Wallace. Touchdown, Seahawks. And 12 yards away. And the Seahawks had 6 to the lead. That connection looked like they may have some good communication. Maybe have them noticed an area that was open to the defense to get the pass to.
When you put the time in, sometimes you have that silent communication that you just noticed right there because the best quarterback receiver combos in the air.
Brown now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And they need them right now because they're trailing.
This is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. To throw is Smith. Escaping the pressure right. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
He could have scanned that ball forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
Smith, an incomplete pass on first down. Now it's second and 10. He'll drop to throw. Right side, this is Morton. 9 yards, not quite enough. Now with third and 1.
A smart move and gets that to the sideline.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and 1. Here we go on fourth. Smith. Over the middle, complete. That's one. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
Man up, man up!
Big play, come on!
So the drive will indeed continue. First and 10 at the 35-yard line. Throwing again is Smith. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
On second and 10, Smith. Oh, this early
struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And the Seahawks are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, oh, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year is your training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Throwing up first down. Wallace. It's Stevens. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving him. That's a good point. Just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you have a zone blitz scheme. And you can draw anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number five. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Just another day in the office.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
Getting the run game going a little bit more because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success. I think these first couple of drives, they want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities. And I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Up the middle they go. Alexander, and he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. To the outside, this is complete to Jackson. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. And that was a heck of a play there on the outside.
Sometimes I think on a play like this as a corner, you've got to think to yourself, all I've got to do is slow him down so others can come over and support. But in this case, he said, forget that. I've got this. Sorry you had to make the run for nothing, fellas.
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. To throw on third down, Wallace. Pass taken away. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 27-yard line. Excellent play there on third down. Give them 25 yards. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 27. Throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
Off play action. Wallace. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. One of the linebackers has got him, and his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. Well, CD, and now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right. Yeah.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble.
Okay, let's make some good calls.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Well, he set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. They get 12 yards back, but it still leads to a fourth and long. And his kick is indeed good, and that will extend their lead even further. And they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with three and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get, keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going.
He's got a man complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. The slot man in motion right. He'll get an opportunity with it on the touch pass. Inside the 35. In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. They run with Golan. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Momentum here, D. They're going to run it here.
On first down, Smith. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had him dropped it. That is an unforced error there, and it takes away what could have been a touchdown. Smith, an incomplete pass on first down. Now it's second and 10. They'll look to throw here. A throw caught here by Martin. Touchdown! A great play there. 26 yards. And the Niners have cut it back within a score. Extra point forthcoming. It's up and got a 7-point margin. It's 20-13 now.
Oh, yeah, we're going to take this down the field, fellas. Blocking up here.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
Another day at the
end. Oh, boy.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter, despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now we'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Flushed out right side here, complete. It'll be a gain of 5.
Thank you.
And that'll bring us to a 3rd and 4. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting to the open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. In the space at the 45. And all the way up to the 46.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, They got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Off the 25. Wallace. And this will move the chains again as the tackle is going to be made at the 49ers' 34-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 34. Now a give right side. It's Alexander. And they eventually get to him at the 17 after a quarter of 17. Into the red zone, first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
We knew both of these safeties were good in run support, but how about the play we just saw there? How about that closing speed? Able to get to the outside part of the field and turn that play into a loss.
To throw on second down, Wallace. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Great effort there. Already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. And the Seahawks will add on to their lead here in the final. Touchdown. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line.
It is.
Woo! The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time. And it's going to be intercepted at prime time. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They'll try the left side. Alexander. And he tries to keep the legs churning, but he's going to be stopped behind the line.
It's a loss of 2. Brings up second and 12. At the Niners' 20-yard line.
Come on, first play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Looking to throw. Wallace eluding the pressure run. First mistake down in the ballgame as it's intercepted. And the Niners are going to get the football back as time will run out in this third quarter of play. So it'll be a change of possession on the turnover when we get back. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Here's Smith. Drops it underneath the goal. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play.
Touchdown, 49ers. A great play there. 3 yards. And the Niners have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter.
Come on, let's run it all the way back. Let's go.
Yeah, put some blocking down the field, fellas.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, if I'm a defender, I'd actually chirp and chill on the other side of the ball and say, hey, what you gonna do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
On first down, it's Alexander over the jerk, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down. They'll keep it on the ground. Alexander. Say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on there.
He's got it! End zone for the Seahawks. Touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Seahawks are closing in on a winning strike to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Touchdown. Oh, yeah. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Another day in the up.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
Paid for this?
What's that?
Come on, guys, we can do better.
They'll run on first down. It's Alexander. What a great effort there. He's going to get this inside the 15, and they'll spot it at the 13-yard line. Nice run. It's a gain of 15, first down Seahawks. It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
I can't believe this.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
A loss of two brings up
second and 12. Man, that was terrible. Awful, seriously, man. Just disgraceful.
Go home.
Ah, no. This could not be worse.
Black Ultra.
Guys.
Did you see the goal line?
Take it to the end zone, fellas.
All the way up.
Back to throw. Wallace. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to drop that off the ground.
The Seahawks on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third down and 12.
Get the job done.
Looking to throw. Wallace. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
Give them credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. As long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum.
So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a 3-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But, you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, 2 scores is tough enough. 3? I'm with you. Woo. That seems out of the question.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. So they'll get 8 out of that completion. And that'll bring up a second down in just a couple. They'll fake the handoff. Now Smith. He hits Beasley right side. As the drive continues, it's a first down.
And they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position. But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many pro style, where you actually have a true fullback. We're having to make do in the NFL and put guys in that spot who emulate it but aren't necessarily that position.
Here's Smith. Flush to his right. Taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down.
Keep it tight, defense.
Smith now to throw. And the timing a bit off that time as that would fall to the ground. We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball. So make sure that the defense receivers on the field. I know the ball is coming out. They got there and popped it free.
Smith throwing again. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Lane. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 35. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. A three-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, we know this little passes are possible. It's anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just 2 scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
Smith, an incomplete pass on first down. Now it's 2nd and 10. On play action, they'll throw. This will be close. He gets all the way down to the 9.
I'm out of here.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. To the air again, Smith. And it's caught. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got it 2nd and goal as they look for a late touchdown. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's 2nd and goal.
Get on it.
Hands on a swivel, boys. Hands on a swivel.
Get on it. Get on it.
Now Smith. And my goodness, another interception. And the Seahawks are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And this is really the start to the season that you're hoping for if you're a coach or a player. They've got to be ready for the fourth quarter. Can really take some time off the clock. 88 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Didn't get to the sticks, but that's an ideal carry there on first down, isn't it?
I mean, now you're 2nd and 1. Although, you know, in the NFL, even if he picked up the first down, I don't think it's a big difference because the clock doesn't stop.
Yeah, not like college.
Right. If it's college football, you want to make something better than picking up the first down because in college football, the clock stops with every first down. It actually aids the defense in that situation.
2 yards in the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
Pushing the run down the field.
All right, offense. Keep pushing the ball.
And they'll indeed take a knee.
Yeah, that's what we do. That is what we do.
Do it all day. Yeah, keep it up, keep it up.
Season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season, and you open within the division. You knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.
So for the Seahawks, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Atlanta Falcons. Meanwhile, for San Francisco, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Glendale to take on the Cardinals. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
Count this money, then I count my blessings. Ooh. If I ever took an L, then it's still for lesson. Yeah. I'm the